Attack of the killer tomatoes. Attack of the killer tomatoes. They'll beat you, bash you, squish you, mash you, chew you up for brunch, and finish you off for dinner or lunch. They're marching down the hall.
What's up, everybody? Mr. Matthew here. This is gardening vlog number 2, where we will be going over before the setup step. If you remember from last week, we started some seeds in a soda candy container, and here they are now, a week later, and as you can see, we got some seeds to sprout. But yeah, like I said, anything could be in container, depending on however many pockets you want in it, or if you just want the one pocket, you know, you can always just have a one container setup. Since I'm shooting for a slightly larger garden, I'll be using a setup that's gonna contain several pockets, a great container for this, easy to get your hands on, is an egg carton, if you remember. But one thing I didn't mention last week was that you're gonna need, for the germination process, a leakage container to catch all the water in case you overwater. So what I'm gonna use a large tinfoil pan. This could range from like $1 to $6 at most, depending on the size of the pan, but a small one, you get one at Dollar Tree for about $1. But yeah, so I'm gonna get this set up and I'll see you in a bit. So here is the complete setup. I just added dirt into the cartons, pat it down a little bit, make sure there's no air pockets. So I did mention earlier how I put holes at the bottom, you can see, so they could leak out, and then it drains it to the tin foil pan. So how sowing the seeds in is gonna work is just for the best results, so you have more opportunity to get your seed started. About 1/4 inch deep, we're gonna put one seed on one corner. And uncover it. And then we're going to go to the other corner. Quarter inch deep. And uncover it. Put the seed in. And that's all it is. I just planted my tomatoes. I'm going to continue sowing the seeds in. We're going to lightly water it. You could use a spray, but a spray bottle. But if you don't have one, a cup of water and just with some light pouring, just don't overwater it. But even if you do, it will leak out, but just try your best not to overwater it. A couple more things about germination. Is light is not necessary for germination. It's actually better for there to be not light. So as you can see, my blinds are closed right now. This is because we want the water to retain longer, so sunlight isn't really needed, a needed nutrient yet, until the plant sprouts. Make sure the temperature that you're keeping your seeds in is gonna be like a 60 to 80 range, as long as it's not too cold and not too hot. But after a few days, you should see it sprout. Maybe it may take a while. And once you see sprouts, I'll be guiding you guys through the next step. So yeah, I hope you guys have a good rest of your day. Mr. Matthew out.